This is Tom Bernacki, and today I'm going over Berberine, nature's Ozempic or Mounjaro. This is the all-natural weight loss drug, and we're starting now. Berberine is getting a ton of hype, and these weight loss supplements are getting a ton of hype. And there's studies for blood sugar control, cholesterol management, weight loss as an anti-inflammatory, an antioxidant, and even an antimicrobial as berberine. So it's definitely studied well, but how much weight do you really use? Is it worth the money? Is it worth taking? How do the numbers stack up against weight loss medications like Ozempic or Mounjaro? So I know that's a sensationalist intro. I'm not promoting one or the other. I stay neutral and look at the studies for you health warriors so you can make a great decision on whether to use these things or not. Berberine is an ancient Chinese medicine derived from various plants, and its popularity is skyrocketing. Everybody's making videos about these things. It's been used in Chinese and Indian medicine in the East for infections, digestive disorders, and for weight loss. It is a naturally occurring compound in roots, stems, and bark of various plants, including golden seal, Oregon grapes, and tree turmeric. On that note, check out our turmeric videos for the best anti-inflammatory available. You'll have to see in the video. There is widespread occurrence in different plants that's extremely unique from most other supplements. It has a vivid color. It's known for its bright yellow color and has historically been used as a yellow dye in wool, leather, and wood. There are a ton of studies on diverse conditions such as nerve diseases, cancers, mental health, weight loss, infections, so it's used for a lot of different stuff. Berberine is one of the few known compounds capable of activating AMP, activated protein kinase, a crucial enzyme in the body that regulates metabolism. This action of berberine is a key reason for its diverse health effects. It also interacts with the gut microbiome. It can potentially impact not just the digestive health, but also systemic health, including glucose metabolism and cardiovascular health. It is often called nature's Ozempic due to its claims of weight loss, improved cardiac health, polycystic ovarian syndrome, symptom relief, and reduced cholesterol levels. Berberine and Ozempic have different mechanisms of action. Ozempic binds to GLP-1 receptors, whereas berberine activates the AMPK enzyme pathway. The benefits of berberine include insulin resistance and weight loss. Berberine may improve insulin resistance and enhance glucose movement into cells, which can contribute to weight loss. It has shown promising results in reducing body fat in clinical trials, partly due to its impact on insulin and glucose metabolism. Heart health. Studies suggest berberine can lower lipid levels, including reducing total cholesterol, LDL cholesterol, and blood triglycerides, while raising the good cholesterol, HDL cholesterol. It may also lower blood pressure when used alongside hypertension medications. Gut health. Berberine could help balance out gut microbiomes by reducing harmful bacteria and promoting good bacteria, potentially protecting against conditions like diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and cancer. Cognitive and lung health. Some research indicates berberine's potential against neurodegenerative disorders and its ability to improve lung health through anti-inflammatory actions. Liver protection and anti-cancer effects. Early research suggests berberine can support liver health by improving glucolipid metabolism.
There are so many studies on berberine, but not a lot of them are high number and high quality. That's why studies like meta-analyses and systematic reviews find the high quality studies and actually look at the proven benefits. So those focus on blood sugar, cholesterol management, those are pretty well proven, but most people Google search weight loss. So we're going to go over that specific number, and it can work really well in some people. Also studied is anti-inflammatory effects, antioxidant effects, and gut microbiome effects.
So what's the dosage that's recommended on berberine? And don't worry, we're going to go over the specific studies and the specific amount of weight you can lose in the specific time frame. The optimal dose can vary, but a common approach is up to 1500 milligrams daily. So 1500 milligrams daily divided into three doses. So about 500 milligrams at a time before meals is the time to take it. This dosing pattern accounts for berberine's short half-life in the body.
How much berberine per day? Most studies centered around 500 to 15 milligrams per day, and it's broken up in about 2 to 3 doses. You want to take it around the same time every day. Just keep a nice schedule. Usually it's preferred to be taken with meals or right after meals while you're still digesting. People who take it on an empty stomach can have the most stomach problems or side effects. Can you take berberine before bed? Yes. If it aligns with your schedule, it's probably not the biggest deal.
So here's kind of the good news, bad news. While it does help you with weight loss, most of the studies are small, poorly conducted. Berberine supplements are not well regulated. So the thing is, like with any supplement, there's caution advised when using them, especially during pregnancy or if you have other health conditions going on. It's important to note that like other supplements, berberine isn't regulated by the FDA. The quality and effectiveness can really vary. Choosing high quality brands with great reviews is probably the easiest way to go about this. The side effects of berberine. Berberine can have side effects like diarrhea, constipation, gassiness. These are usually pretty common. While they can happen, they're not the most common, and berberine is considered to be pretty safe.
Is there any studies on berberine dangers? Well, it's not metabolized in the kidneys, which is the great news. Usually people with kidney disease have to worry about taking any type of supplement, but in this case, berberine is metabolized by the liver. So the kidney should be safe, although there's never a guarantee with anything. On the other hand, the liver, you have to be careful when taking medications metabolized by the liver, like Tylenol, for example, or anything toxic. And in the short term and medium term, berberine was found to be safe on the liver, but there's no significant long-term use studies performed. Thus, anything could happen. You have to be careful. There's no indication that it does cause liver damage, but there's just not a guarantee that it doesn't. So be careful with other medications.
Another thing to be concerned about is if you're on a lot of different medications, particularly ones processed by the liver, you have to contact your doctor. So if you have liver problems or you're on other liver digesting medications like Tylenol, as an example, then you have to be careful with berberine.
Because it's processed in the liver, a lot of things can interact with it. Antibiotics, blood sugar medications, blood thinners. If you're pregnant, it's not really approved or recommended. If you're on antipsychotic medications and some gastrointestinal, cardiac, and neurological medications, check with your doctor if you're on a ton of medications.
So here's the big secret on berberine. It has been the subject of various well-studied analyses and randomized controlled trials focusing on its cardiovascular disease effects, its metabolic effects like helping type 2 diabetes.
Wow, berberine is amazing for the kidneys. This meta-analysis looked at 25 studies averaging 8 to 12 weeks, and the kidney markers improved significantly in early stage kidney disease or chronic kidney disease. Better fasting blood glucose, better blood urea nitrogen, serum creatinine. They used a kidney index score, which did improve, and it also lowered inflammatory blood markers like cholesterol levels, interleukin 6, and tumor necrosis alpha. And in almost all these studies, there was no major side effects taking the standard dosage. These are really impressive results, especially because this is metabolized by the liver. Is this an option for your kidneys if you have chronic kidney disease? Maybe something to ask your nephrologist or primary care doctor for sure.
One large-scale review and randomized controlled trials looked at 44 different studies with berberine with 4,606 patients. Berberine used alone can help reduce the levels of total cholesterol, triglycerides, low-density lipoproteins, and decrease C-reactive protein. C-reactive protein is an inflammatory marker.
Aren't you glad you have a foot doctor telling you about your ovarian syndrome? But these are unbelievable studies. Reduced testosterone, lower insulin resistance, then with metformin alone, less inflammatory markers, less blood sugar, less inflammatory markers, less SDL cholesterol. These are actually really impressive studies and exciting.
In these studies, it also did help when evaluating the thickness of arteries. In pretty much all of these 66 studies, berberine was noted to be pretty safe with no significant differences or adverse reactions compared to the other control treatments. Another study looked at type 2 diabetes with 46 different studies analyzed. This meta-analysis revealed that berberine, either used alone or in conjunction with other diabetic therapies, significantly lowered the glycated hemoglobin. So the hemoglobin A1C, fasting plasma glucose, and 2-hour postprandial, that means post-eating glucose level. It also improved insulin resistance markers. After 3 months or so on average, it did help decrease the weight a little bit.
So this study did a great job looking at the individual studies. So there's 40 plus of them, and you can see the average week of the studies was about 8 to 12 weeks. The blood sugar actually dropped the hemoglobin A1C by about 0.75, which is excellent, and it lowered the fasting glucose by a decent amount. The cholesterol management showed that fats and cholesterol, the bad cholesterol, was decreased, and weight loss decreased by an average BMI of 1.07, and there was no real side effects. So these are actually really good studies. The more I dig into this after I finished recording this video, the better the results actually seem. And a lot of these studies compared berberine and metformin to metformin alone, which is a diabetes medication. And the berberine plus the metformin usually had better studies.
But when we look at specific numbers, what do you think it was? 30 pounds of weight loss? It's more like 5 pounds. Me personally, I don't prescribe things like Ozempic myself, but a lot of the people that I work with do in our offices. And I have seen patients lose significant amounts of weights, like 50 pounds, 100 pounds. This is not quite the extent of treatment you're gonna get with something like berberine, but it is possible to accomplish these. And at the same time, medications, losing that much weight all at once could have its own side effects. And you're kind of reading that in the news right now. And going back to these diabetes studies, berberine did lower the triglyceride levels, the total cholesterol levels, and the LDL levels. So to summarize, we're looking at 100 plus studies that we just looked at in this video. Berberine, while it does help, on average, I kind of found that after about 3 months, the weight loss was in the 5 pound range, which is okay. It's better than nothing. And the cholesterol did decrease. And when I say decrease, we're talking like 5% range or so. We're not talking like 50% weight loss. We're not talking like 50% cholesterol loss. So specifically, one of the major studies was a 12-week study in 2012. When people take 3 dosages of 500 milligrams of berberine, they lost an average of 5 pounds, which is pretty good. And almost all studies did show that berberine helped lose weight and the waist circumference did decrease. But at the same time, in 2020, there was another meta-analysis that looked at even more studies, and they found some did have great results, some had medium to almost no results. There was another group of 10 studies that found that berberine supplementation over a couple months had almost no result. Another study looked at the results for dosage. If you've taken over 1 gram or 1,000 milligrams of berberine per day, that usually had better results. If you took less, it usually did not have as good a result.
So in general, taking about 1500 milligrams had better results than taking 500 milligrams. You want to take it consistently. Yes, you can take it before bed. You can take it on an empty stomach, but it can irritate you just a little bit more. You generally want to take it with a meal. Avoid the empty stomach. You might get some irritation, but that's how you lose about 5 to 6 pounds every 8 to 12 weeks, according to the studies.
These studies suggest that berberine may have a modest effect on weight loss. However, we're looking at like 5 pounds over 3 months. By controlling your diet, by strength training, by doing cardio, by sleeping better, you can probably achieve significantly better results. But berberine seems to be very well studied. It does help at this point. But this is the beauty of this channel. Probably the viewers that watch this video, it's gonna be more than the 4,000 people that responded to this study. So if berberine helped you, this is huge for this channel. Tell me down below, what's your experiences? Did berberine help? Are you feeling better on it? Did you lose weight? It's really important you're helping out other people in the comments. If that helped, check out my videos on other things like turmeric, curcumin as an anti-inflammatory for potential weight loss. Check out those studies.